Hello everyone, welcome back to Mamta Nirwal tutorial. And guys, in this video we're going to start a new chapter, chapter number 12, and the name of the chapter is electricity and circuit. Okay, how our electricity help us to glow up in our homes. Okay, like normally why we use electricity? We use electricity to operate a pump. Okay, what kind of a pump? Like if we need to lift some water from the ground level to the rooftop. Okay, to the rooftop, we require a lot of muscles if we need to do it by our muscles. So instead of that, we can make our work easy with the help of pump. So we provide electricity to the pump, and that pump will help us to put or lift the water from ground level to the rooftop. Okay, so this is how we can make our work easy with the help of electricity. What else we can use? Like electricity we can use to light our home. Okay, when there is no light, we can use it as electricity, we can use as a source of light, so that or we can say that a bulb required a source of electricity to glow up properly. So light our homes, roads, office, or we can say market or any other places, even after the sunset, we can glow up that area with the help of the electricity. Okay, so what is the main function of electricity, or why we require it? To continue working even at the night. Even at night we can continue our work. We do not need to stop it because there is no light and we are not able to see objects around us. No, because of the electricity we can see and we can work even at the night also. Okay, from where this electricity come from? So the electricity is come from or provided by the power station. Okay, from the power station we get the electricity to our homes. Okay, now the electricity, if the electricity is not available, what we do? We use to switch on our torch. Okay, so torch will provide light to us in the absence of electricity or a electricity which we are getting from the power station. Okay, so how the torch, what is present in the torch which glow up, or we can say that bulb is a part which lights up, and this lights up when we turn on the switch. Okay, that means when we switch on the torch, we can say that the bulb is the portion which glow up and provide us light. Okay, so what is that bulb? What that bulb taking the electricity from? The bulb is taking electricity from the electric cell. Okay, the electric cell which we put inside the torch. This is the torch, this is the face of the torch, and there is the bulb. Now where is the cell? We place the cell inside that torch here. So from that cells the torch will get, or the bulb will get the electricity to glow up. Okay, so what are the electric cells? The cells which we use for the arm clock, the alarm clock. Okay, or we can say that the our wrist watch. Okay, the cells we require to, like in the wrist watches we require cells, or our transistors, or we can say that the in the radio. Okay, in the radio we require electric cells, or we can say that like in cameras also we require electric cell. Okay, so these are the electric cells, and from where these electric cells are getting this chemical, or from where this electric cell getting the electricity. So the electricity is produced in the electric cell through the chemicals which is present, which is stored in that cell. Okay, so the chemical which is stored inside that cell, this chemical will provide us the electricity. Okay, so what is the normal structure of a cell? This is a normal cell, and here you can see there is a cap type of structure. So this is the metal cap and this is the metal disc. Okay, so one side if you see a normal cell, electric cells, what you see, one side there is a metal cap kind of a structure, and here is the metal disc kind of a structure you can see. Okay, so the portion or the terminal where it is metal cap is present is known as the positive terminal. This is the positive terminal. Okay, and the side in which the metal disc is present is the negative. So this is the negative terminal. So in short, we can say that our cell normally has two terminal. One is the positive one and one is the negative one. Okay, so two terminals are present in a normal cell. Okay, if this chemical, like we already discussed, that this chemical will provide the electricity, this chemical will make the electricity, due to which that bulb will glow up. Okay, if there is a chance this chemical is over, or we can say that this chemical is used up, okay, then what happen after used up the all the chemical in the cell, this cell will stop working. Okay, so now the cell will not produce any electricity, and due to which the bulb will also not glow. So now we cannot see any glowing bulb in the cell or in the torch if the cell is, the cell chemical is already used up. Okay, so this is all about the cell. Now we will talk what is the bulb and what is the structure of bulb and how it work. So this is the structure of bulb, this is the base of that bulb, and this is the terminal, and here you can see a filament, and this is how it normal structure. Okay, so this is our bulb, this is the filament. What is this? This is the filament. What is filament? It is a thin wire which give us light. Okay, this is the thing which give us light or provide us the light. Okay, after that, this, what are these? These are the terminals. These are the terminals. And always keep in mind, like always, these terminals are never touch each other. They never touch each other, because if the terminal will connect each other, then the bulb will fuse. Okay, so always the terminals are on different sides and they never touch each other. Okay, now what are this? This is the thick wire. This is the thick wire, and that thick wire will connected to the positive terminal from one side. Like this is the positive, from one side it is connected to the positive one, and from the other side it is connected to the negative terminal. Okay, so this is the thick wire which is connected from both positive as well as negative terminal and the filament. Okay, so this is how our normal structure of bulb we can see. Okay, now how the electric current work, or we can say that for the electricity to work, so what is electric circuit? Okay, so to complete that electric, if we have a complete electric circuit, then only we can see that light is glowing, or we can say that the bulb is glowing. Okay, so this is the cell, just assume this is a cell and this is our bulb. Okay, so this is the filament of the bulb and this is the outer structure. So now how the first one wire should be connected to the one terminal and other wire will be connected to the other terminal of the cell as well as the bulb. And if this terminal or if this wire is complete, the circuit is complete, then only our bulb will glow up, otherwise it will not. Okay, so normally what is electric circuit? What we say, it provide us a complete path. Okay, what it provide? A complete path for the electricity to pass through. Okay, normally to pass the electricity we require a complete path. Okay, so to what is electricity? The flow of current. The current flow is known as the electricity. Okay, where it flow? Between the two terminals of the electric cell. Okay, where is the electric cell? This is the electric cell, this is the positive terminal, this is the negative terminal. So in this, this is the complete circuit, what the complete path which they need to follow, who need to follow the electric flow, or we can say that current flow should follow the complete path. If it is complete, then we can say that the electric circuit is complete, and then we can say that the bulb will glow. Okay, the bulb will glow. Okay, now the current, if the current is not present, then what happen? If the circuit is completed, this is our bulb and this is our cell, but the cell chemical is used up, because of which no current is generated in that wire. What happened now? The bulb will not glow. Bulb will not glow because there is no current. So what is important? Always the bulb will glow when current flows through the circuit. Okay, this is the main concept. Where the current, the direction of the current, what is the direction of current in the circuit? It should be from positive to negative terminal. Always keep in mind, like, always the terminal, from positive terminal to negative terminal, always the current will flow. Okay, so this is the main concept. Now sometime we can see that there is a fused bulb, okay, or sometime there is a current but there is electricity, but still our bulb is not working. Why? Most of the time the case is that this is our bulb and this is our filament and this is the tungsten portion. So what happened? This filament is removed or breaked up. Because of the breaking of this filament, the circuit is not complete now. So due to the not completing the circuit of the current, because of which the bulb cannot glow. Because to glow the bulb, we require to complete that circuit. And the circuit is not completing because there is a breakage in the filament. So to remove this problem or to solve this problem, we need to replace it with another bulb or a new bulb which has a proper connected filament. Okay, so this is how the fused bulb, we can say that the bulb is fused because the filament is not attached. Okay, now what is electric switch? What is electric switch? How it works? Normally we talk about the electric circuit, that is very clear. What is the electric circuit? This is the bulb, this is the cell, and this is the bulb. Okay, and this is a cardboard. Okay, here the cell is connected with the bulb, okay, terminal of the bulb, and here it is connected with the box, wooden box, or we can say cardboard. Okay, so these are the pins. Okay, so these are the board pins, and board pins are made up of metal. So metal is a good conductor of electricity, that's why we have used pin into it. So here what we have used, like, these are the board pins, and these board pins are connected with the wire, and which can make a complete circuit. Okay, but there is a breakage here. What we have used? We have used a safety pin. Okay, this is a safety pin, and safety pin is also made up of metal, so it is a good conductor. So if the safety pin is attached to the other terminal, or we can say the other board pin, this is the board pin 1, this is the board pin 2. So if they are attached to each other, complete the circuit, then the circuit will complete and the bulb will glow because the circuit is complete now. And if there is a chance, like, now normally how the circuit is off or how the switch is off, if the safety pin is away from their another board pin, so what we see, there is a gap between them, and because of this gap the circuit is not completed. So this is how, what we see, like, normally if the board pin is attached to the one board pin to another board pin, then we can say that this is the on, the switch is on. Or if we say that this is the board pin 1, 2 and the safety pin is here. There is a gap between the other board pin, so we can say that the switch is off for that circuit. Okay, so circuit need to be complete if to glow the bulb, and if the we do not require to glow that bulb, we can make it off by removing it from that portion. So this is how we can remove it from that terminal, and because of which the circuit will break, and due to that breakage in the circuit will not complete and the bulb will stop glowing. Okay, so this is how a switch works. So normally, what is switch? It is a simple device that either break the circuit, okay, that have the ability to either break the circuit or it can complete the circuit. Both the ability it contain. If it break the circuit, then the bulb, or we can say that the bulb will off, okay, it's switched off. If the circuit is complete, then we can say that the thing is switched on. Okay, so this is how our electric switch work. What are the electric conductors and insulator? This is the last concept of this chapter which you need to understand. What is the meaning of the conductor? Conductor is that the material, any material which allow electricity or electric current to pass through them. Okay, so what is the material which allow the electric current to pass through them is known as the conductor. And what are the insulator which do not allow electric current to pass through it. Okay, current to pass through it. So this is what insulators are. What is the example of a conductor? What are the conductors? Like, if we talk about the metals, all the metals are a good conductor of electricity, or we can say our own body also. We are very good conductor of electricity. So the electric current can follow very easily, pass through our body. Okay, same as for the metal also. These are the conductor of electricity. What are the insulators? Insulators are like rubber. They do not allow to pass the electricity through them. The rubber, the plastics, or we can say wood. So that's why all these things are made up of, like our switch are made up of what? Plastics mostly. Why? Our electric plugs are made up of rubbers or plastic. Why? Because they are insulated. That will help us to make the object shock proof. We do not get any shock because it is a insulator and it do not allow the electricity to pass through it. We can easily handle it with our normal hands. Okay, so all these are the insulator are the things which do not allow the electric current to pass through it. And if the material is allowed to the electric current to pass through them are known as the conductor. So all those are the conductor which allow the electricity to pass through it. Okay, so guys, this is what all in this chapter. I hope you understand all these concepts. If you have any doubt, please ask me in the question, in the comment box. And thank you guys for watching this video.